They were trying to do something else while they were actually walking on the crazy chaotic streets of New York City. I mean, how out of your mind do you have to be, right? I don't know if you've ever been to New York City, but those people there don't drive very well. And they're kind of angry. I don't know if you've ever heard of them or not, but I came across a quote from this dude named Aristotle. I know, weird name, right? And the quote said, "We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not an act, but a habit." Now, obviously, I'm being sarcastic about the whole knowing who Aristotle is thing, but Aristotle definitely was not being sarcastic when he said those famous words. See, he knew even way back then, around 350 BC, that habits are the make or break factor that determines whether or not someone is able to create great success in their life. See, you can't create great success with a bunch of bad habits. That's why I want to talk to you about five common bad habits you need to make sure that you break if you want to create and live an awesome life. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Welcome to the Life Hack Show. I'm your host, Justin Aldridge, and today we're going to talk about some common bad habits that tend to hold people back from creating the lives that they desire. But before we dive into that, I want to tell you about a great resource that we've created for you here at Life Hack. You see, by you being here, we know that you're somebody who wants to live an awesome life. And it's for people just like you that we created our three-step guide to break free and design the life that you want. So click on the link above or down in the description below to go and download that tool. And also, if you're enjoying our content, go ahead and hit that like button and subscribe to our channel so that you get notified each and every time that we put out new, great content. With that being said, let's hop on over to the whiteboard and let's start talking about some of these habits. The first bad habit that we're going to talk about is procrastination. See, so many people struggle with procrastination and it prevents them from being able to really go out and start taking the action that they want to be taking in the directions of their goals, their dreams, and their aspirations. And if you go back to our video on goal setting, when I reviewed the SMART goal model, there's a reason why I spent so much time emphasizing the T, which stands for time bound. And it's because every single goal that you have needs to have a deadline so that you prevent procrastination. The reason why you need that time bound structure is because it creates urgency. It creates that need to go out and start taking action. There's that old saying that a goal will expand to fill the amount of time that it's given. Meaning that if you don't ever set a hard time limit on a goal, the likelihood that you're going to achieve it becomes slim and none. So if you want to be serious about actually creating a life that you desire, creating an amazing life where you're able to go out and do a lot of really great things, you've got to start putting time limits on your goals so that you can avoid procrastination. Because we know when you procrastinate, you don't put out your best work. Think back on a time that you procrastinated. Did you put out great quality work? You waited right up until that last absolute minute to be able to get the thing done that you needed to get done, even though you probably had a bunch of time before that to be able to work on it. Be honest, did you put out your best work? Chances are the answer is no. When we procrastinate, we get in this rushed state. We get in this state where we have all this hurried energy. And when we have that energy, we just don't put out quality work. And we need quality work in order to take us to where we want to go. People who are putting out low quality, less than stellar work don't create great lives. So don't be one of those people. Stop procrastinating. Put time limits on your goals so that you can actually start creating what it is that you actually desire in your life rather than settling for what you don't want. The second bad habit you need to break if you want to live an awesome life is not setting intention. A lot of people are waking up every single day and they are just reacting to everything that's happening in life. They are what we call reactive rather than proactive. Well, it's the proactive people in this world who are really able to create great, successful lives for themselves. And the reason why is because being proactive requires you to actually plan. It requires you to sit down and create a plan of action for how you're going to go about creating what it is that you desire. It's creating the roadmap for your success. But a lot of people, they may sit down and they may think about like the goals or the dreams that they have, but they don't actually create a daily operating plan, the things that they're going to do in order to create the results every single day that are going to lead them in the direction that they want to go. See, it's one thing to have great goals. It's another thing to actually sit down and create a plan that's going to allow you to achieve the goals. But if you want to live a great life, you've got to do the, I guess, less fun part of success, which is planning. It's like that old saying, if it were easy, everyone would do it. Well, when it comes to setting intention, that is your mental framework for how you want to show up, what it is that you want to get done. It's all encompassing about you stepping into the identity of the person that you want to be so that you can then create the success that you want to create in your life. You can't just go out there and just freewheel it and just willy-nilly start taking action and just doing random things. No, you've got to have a set plan in place and you've got to take action according to the plan. Think about building a house. All right. Whenever they go out there and they start building a house, they don't just start grabbing boards and throwing them up places, hoping that it's going to create this beautiful structure. No, they sit down and they set the intention for what that house is supposed to look like. They create all of these elegant just plans and maps and all of these great things that are going to be resources that are going to allow them to create the house that they're envisioning. That's what setting intention does. It allows you to know, how do I need to show up and what do I need to be doing so that I can create the life that I actually want to create. So if you want to be successful, start setting an intention every single day for what it is that you want to get done and how you want to show up. The third bad habit that we're going to chat about is multitasking. All right, I'm going to raise my hand and admit guilt to the fact that I used to think that I was great at multitasking. And I'm sure you could probably relate to that as well. As high achievers, we tend to think that we can do all of these different things and we can be great at it. And now, while we may be better than someone who's not as high of an achiever, nobody is good at multitasking. And it's actually proven by science. Whenever you go and you look at the research, it shows that cognitive performance is significantly reduced when we try to multitask. And the reason why is because our brains can't learn multiple things at once. We've got to have focused energy in one area in order to be able to actually start bringing new information in, setting it into our mind, and locking it into our long-term memory. When we go out and we start trying to multitask, we actually break what's called our flow state, which is that awesome state that we always want to be in whenever we're going out there, we're putting out our best work, and we're just producing at a really high level. Well, when you multitask, you break that state and you don't allow yourself to get there in any of the tasks that you're actually doing. It's called task changing. And when you're continuing to do that, you're constantly breaking that flow state, which is not allowing you to put out your best quality work. And actually, if you go in and you look even deeper at the research on multitasking, there are some very significant physical and psychological effects that come along with somebody who tries to multitask at a high level and for long durations. Depression and anxiety tend to be higher in people who try to multitask on a regular basis. There's negative side effects on the brain, like reduced gray matter, in people who have multitasked for long periods of time. And it also shows that it reduces your IQ. So if the fact that you're not just putting out your best work isn't enough to prove to you that this is a very, very bad habit, go and look at the research and just see the adverse effects that it's having on your physical body and your brain so that you should know that you need to stop multitasking. All right, one more piece of evidence that will really drive home this point about not multitasking. I saw a piece of research that showed that 1,400 people got ran over in New York City. Guess what 20% of them were doing? Multitasking. They were trying to do something else while they were actually walking on the crazy chaotic streets of New York City. I mean, how out of your mind do you have to be, right? I don't know if you've ever been to New York City, but those people there don't drive very well. And they're kind of angry. So, going back to my original point, stop multitasking. It's having a horrible effect on your body and your brain, and you're not putting out great work, which means you're not creating the life that you want to create for yourself. So stop multitasking, focus your energy in one area, and become great at something. All right, number four is perfectionism. Now, again, just like multitasking, I gotta raise my hand and say that I am a recovering perfectionist. We'll just call it that. When you think about perfectionism, when it goes back to number one, procrastination, that's what perfectionism is. It is a form of procrastination. You know, there's a reason why that old saying is true, done is better than perfect, because perfect doesn't exist. Well, it's true. There's nothing out there that's ever going to be perfect. And if you're striving for that in your life, in your career, in your relationships, whatever area it might be, you're gonna find that you're always going to come up short and that you're always going to be unsatisfied, because you're never going to find the perfection that you're seeking. So if you're one of those people, you can raise your hand just like me and you could say, I am a perfectionist. Understand that all you're doing is you're procrastinating. And a lot of times, the reason why we're perfectionists is because we have a fear of judgment. We're afraid that if we put something out there too early, before it's perfect, that people are gonna judge us. So we sit there and we procrastinate, and we call it perfectionism. So you've gotta break that habit. You gotta step out of that. You gotta understand that done is always better than perfect, because perfect will never exist. And then finally, the last bad habit that you need to break is neglecting your physical health. All right, the way that I want you to start thinking about your body is as a car. All right, this is going to be the vehicle that's going to deliver you to the destination. We all know that in modern times, we need cars to get around. But if we're not taking care of the vehicle that we've been given, we can't arrive at the destination. It's going to break down on the side of the road. And that's what's going to happen to us. We're going to break down in life. As high achievers, we tend to put ourselves under great levels of stress. That's just part of the process of creating a great life for yourself. So if you're not taking care of your physical health, something that's going to allow you to significantly reduce the effects of the stress that you're putting yourself under, then you're going to fold. You're going to break down on the side of the road. And when it comes to making your health a priority, there are three things that you need to make sure that you're focusing on: exercising, nutrition, and sleep. You've got to make sure every single day that you are taking in proper nutrition. You can't fuel up a car with old junky fuel and expect that it's going to run well. Well, that's what food to our body is. Our nutrition is the fuel that's running our automobile, our car. The second thing is that you need to make sure that you're moving your body every single day. That does not mean that you have to go out there and you've got to do a back-breaking physical workout. No. Nobody can hold up under that sort of stress. But you do need to be moving your body every single day, because doing so allows you to start creating and releasing the chemicals that you need in your body that create physical energy. It allows you to take your performance to the next level, because you're gonna have more energy than the vast majority of people around you. And then the third thing, the most underrated thing in today's society, is getting rest. We always want to go out there and we want to burn the midnight oil, hoping that that's going to get us to where we want to go faster. But it's actually the opposite. When we do that, when we continue to do that for long periods of time, we actually break our body down faster. So we prevent ourselves from being able to create any success and momentum in the direction that we're wanting to go. So you got to make sure that you're getting the rest that you need. So make your physical health a priority. When you do that, it's going to allow you to start showing up from an energetic place that you want to show up from, so that you can start creating the life and the goals that you have for yourself. So there you go. There they are. The five bad habits that you need to make sure that you break if you want to live an amazing life. Do me a favor, in the comments below, let me know which one of these five most resonates with you and is something that you know you're guilty of and you need to break. And also, before we go, I want to tell you about a great community that we have here at Lifehack. It's our free Facebook group where like-minded men and women come together to connect and encourage each other in the direction of their goals. So if you want to connect with other driven, ambitious people who are striving to create their best lives, click on the link below and go and join our free community. With that being said, that concludes this video. Hop on over to lifehack.org for more great tips, tools, and resources just like this, or stay tuned for the next video.